The challenge for the government in enhancing electricity access to all Kenyans has been the fact that generating and supplying electricity to remote and sparsely populated areas is expensive and at times makes no economic sense to put up transmission lines. However, the government hopes that commissioning of a mini-grid substation in Garissa by President Uhuru Kenyatta last week, followed by the commissioning of 19 other mini-grid stations, will enhance electricity access in remote areas.
So if you are going to build a transmission line 700 kilometers, you can see the cost. And then also vis-a-vis the customer population, because you see, if you build a transmission line to 10 people, you're spending 3.3 billion. Are you going to get back that money? So it's sometimes easy to say, fine, instead of doing the transmission line, why can we use maybe the solar system? Why can we use the generator? Which it is still expensive, but not like when you are building them, those that transmission.
To further enhance these efforts, the government is seeking 10 billion shillings from the World Bank to finance the development of mini-grid connections in remote areas. This will also involve putting up solar power and wind power projects within the next 4 years.
These off-grid areas are very expensive. The cost is very expensive, and we need to devise methods of getting mini grids which are affordable, which are cheap, so that the overall cost of power will come down.
With the cost of power from mini grid stations ending up being expensive at times, though designed for the marginalized, Keter hopes that an ongoing forum by mini grid energy experts will provide innovative solutions to these.
The tariff, since power generated at off grid is normally more costly than grid power. Access to financing for service providers and consumers. What happens when the grid arrives? Also, when the grid is done, what happened to the mini grids? Those are challenges which we need to overcome as we embark on these activities.
Close to 108 institutions in off-grid areas will be connected with the power from solar projects in the next financial year. Nicholas Ndwati, NewsHour Business.